I have with me here a mini PC. It's from a company that's called Pepper Jobs. You've probably never heard of them. Neither had I until they reached out and said to me, hey, do you want to review our new Gemini Lake mini PC? Now this is called the GLK-UC2X. It's a bit of a mouthful. And it is powered by the Sauron N4100. And the good thing about this PC and why it is interesting and why I decided, yeah, I will check it out, I'll review it for you, is because this one has some upgrade abilities. We've got SODIMM slots on there, two of them. It comes pre-configured with only 4 gigabytes, which is not a lot. Ideally, I'd like to see at least 8 gigabytes, and even better would be dual channel. It's just got the single stick in there, so you can add an additional 4 gigabytes. It will even run up to 16 gigabytes, even though that is not actually officially supported. It says like 8 gigabytes max, but it does work, and I'll show you that later on working. So this mini PC also has 3 display outs on it. You can add your own SATA 3 SSD in it, and you can even change the wireless card. So plenty of upgradeability. It's actively cooled, so there's a little fan in there. So let's check it out. Inside the box, you will find our power supply, which is rated to 12 volts, 3 amps output. It does have 3 interchangeable heads. So one for the UK, one for the US, one for Europe, an HDMI cable, and a quick start guide. So the mini PC here is made entirely of plastic, so a full plastic build. There are vents around the side. We've got the Pepper Jobs logo on the top, and it's a quality plastic they have used. There's nothing wrong with this build quality. Ports on the mini PC is one area that it really excels here. So we have a 3.5mm headphone jack with mic support. We've got USB 3.1. This, of course, does support power delivery, so you can power this whole mini PC just off Type-C. It does support 4K. And also HDMI 2.0a, that's 4K 60Hz, and then mini display out, gigabit LAN, and then DC in for power. On the right, you'll find an exit vent here. So yes, it is actively cooled with a little fan inside. I'll give you a sample of the fan noise later on, and thermals, of course, in this review. So this means we can increase the power limit because it's got a fan. Now, normally, the Gemini Lake, the N4100, is passively cooled, so it doesn't even have any fans, but here it does. There's a button there for a reset if you happen to mess up one of the settings in the BIOS, and then a Kensington lock slot. And then finally, the front or the left side, depending on the way you look at it, we've got a power on button, micro SD card here, 2 USB 3 ports, a Type-C USB 3, so this is just data only. And then lastly, my favorite part here. So there's 2 little hatches on the back here, one for RAM, so you can upgrade the RAM. It comes with 4 gigabytes of double data rate for 2400 pre-installed, so you can put an additional 4 in there to make it 8, and then dual channel. We can add a 2280 SATA 3 SSD, and even our wireless card is upgradable here. You just need to unglue where those antennas are, and you could swap that over for an even faster Intel 9000 series one if you wanted to. So it's really good to see all this upgradability, because normally the wireless card definitely is not upgradable, and most of these mini PCs that I review have, of course, the RAM soldered onto the motherboard. Now, it does look to have 2 mounting supports. You can see one here and one here, probably for a VESA mount bracket, but unfortunately that's not included in the box. It must be an optional accessory. So here is our BIOS. Just wanted to show you that you can install 16 gigabytes of RAM, even though the manual will say 8 gigabytes maximum support. Even Intel say that with their Intel Nook that I reviewed, but it does work, and it is running at 2.4 gigahertz. Now, we do have a few settings in here. So if you go into the advanced menu, we've got CPU configuration where we can tweak the power limit. This is the TDP unlocker. By default, it's on 10, but I'm gonna set this to 12. It will increase the temperatures a little bit, but in my testing, it's gonna be actually fine. You might get a little bit more fan noise. And if you go over to the hardware monitor right here, we can also adjust a few settings with the fan. So by default, it's on balance. You can set that on to silent, so the fan will try not to come on as much, high performance, and just full on mode there if you were gonna be just constantly gaming on it or doing something like that. Not that you probably would with this spec anyway. So you can adjust a couple of the settings here that when the fan actually comes on and when you want it to go on to the full mode, which is 100%, and that's when it gets a little bit loud. That's when it hits 80 degrees, which doesn't happen often. When you first power it on, you get the selection screen, and just wanted to show you this, that it does have a lot of languages here covered. So we've got English, German, Spanish, French, Chinese, Dutch, and Russian. So the mini PC is running Windows 10 Pro, as you can see. It's not the latest version, 1803, so you need to run Windows Update, obviously, to get that all up to date with everything. Now, I have installed a 512 gigabyte SSD,
and that works just fine with the proper speeds that you would expect. And here is the C drive, so you get 36.5 gigabytes free. So here is our CPU, it's the Intel Celeron N4100, I've reviewed a lot of them now. Maximum turbo is 2.4 gigahertz, and if you're over just a single thread, then it's going to be 2.3, and it will hold this mini PC 2.3 on all four cores, which is really good. And if we have a look now at our wireless, it's the Intel Wireless AC3165. Maximum throughput is about 390 megabits per second. And the graphics is handled by Integrated Graphics, which is Intel's UHD Graphics 600. I've tested it, 4K, 60 hertz, working from the HDMI port, and also tested it working via the mini display port as well, 60 hertz, no problem there, which is great. Now we'll take a look at a couple of benchmarks. So this is the OpenCL score, which of course is the GPU. It's not bad for this chipset. And the Geekbench 4 score here. So it is on par with other tech I've reviewed with the Gemini Lake Celeron N4100. There's no real change here because if you have a look at the benchmark I did just recently with the TechLast F7 Plus, and that one gets a slightly lower single core score, but the multi-core score there more or less the same. So that's fine. And then we have a look at the Emmc. It's a SanDisk they've gone with, 64 gigabytes. And the speeds are very good here. For this type of drive, it's probably, in fact, one of the highest I have seen. General performance of this mini PC, considering the spec, is very good. But remember, I am running now 16 gigabytes of RAM and in dual channel. If you put 8 in and it's dual channel, you can expect the same kind of performance here. But the more RAM, of course, the more you can multitask. So right now, I'm going to play a very demanding file here. This is 140 megabits per second 4K. And you can see that that loads up very quick. Just skip ahead. No problems with that. In fact, this is decoding this natively, of course, with the GPU. If you have a look now at the performance, and just bring this up right now, that it shouldn't be taxing it too much, although the CPU is being pushed a little bit hard here for some reason by the system. But that is all pretty normal, and that runs it really well. And if I take a look now at YouTube, let's just load in the YouTube page, run a 4K video. Okay, and let's just try and find the 4K demo. Bring that up, and this will stream it perfectly fine here. I'm just going to mute this sound for copyright reasons. And let's just set this now to 4K. It's already on 4K. Two drop frames at the start, but it's going to be able to keep up with this, no problem. And I haven't noticed any issues with the wireless antenna. This is probably the reason why they decided to go with a plastic housing on this mini PC. It doesn't inhibit the signal reception whatsoever. You can see that's keeping up fine. Would help if I push play. And that is working as you can see. So 4K streaming, not a problem here. So close that down. I have got in the background, you can see here, Photoshop. You're able to do basic edits. You can even encode video, but I would stick to 1080p and be prepared for some very lengthy encoding times as well with that. I've got Kodi here too, open that up. Spreadsheets, docs, and things like that, performance is gonna be just fine for that. And you can see Kodi is right here. So what I'll do is just find the video and pull this off the removable disk I put in here. So this is off the SD card slot. So they're a little bit slower. And just find under my demo clips right here, load this up. And actually that popped in way faster than I expected it to. And you can see 60 frames per second that is playing at. So no problems with that. Kodi's handling that really good. Now I'm gonna do my little Chrome multi-tab performance test here. So I'm just gonna do anything random. Let's just type in dogs here and start just opening up a huge amount of tabs, getting them all to open up in the background. We'll see how things perform, how long this is gonna take to load up. So I'm just going along and opening up every single thing here I can find. And we'll see just how well this performs. To me, it seems like an older generation Core i5, like about the fourth or fifth gen when you're doing these kind of tests here, and like a Core i3 really. So let's have a look. These have all opened in. You can see that seems to be loading up pretty fast. No problems here really switching between things. Still got a lot of stuff loading in, of course. And really this performance I do find to be really good considering that this is just a, of course, very low spec quad core here. And that is pretty good. not bad at all, that performance. You can see scrolling performance, very smooth there, fluid. And let's bring that back. So that YouTube video as well, that's playing there in the background. And that all seems to be really good. So the performance, I find, it really doesn't feel like a Celeron N4100, especially with the 16 gigabytes of RAM that I have installed and running in dual channel. And looking at gaming performance now, so this is League of Legends, which I test all the time on this kind of hardware, and this is performing really well. I've got five other bots, and we've got a frame rate of normally over 60 frames per second here, which is really good. So it's very smooth, playable. This is on the medium graphics setting. So if you increase it, of course, the frame rate's going to drop down a little bit there. But overall, this is probably one of the better performances actually I've seen of this hardware and this game. Now taking a look at Counter-Strike Global Offensive, you can see that we're getting a very good frame rate here considering this is low settings, 720p. And normally on some of the tech I review, it's much lower than this. This is about around 30 frames per second. So the performance is really good because of the 12 watt TDP I have set there, of course. And I am dead. And now Grand Theft Auto, this is running in 800x600, about 30 frames per second. It does dip down to about 21 when there's a lot going on screen. So it's just playable. You have to keep it on the lower settings. And it is good to see this hardware, such low-end hardware, able to run a demanding game like this. But you can see now that frame rate's about 22, 21 frames per second when there is a lot on screen. And looking now at our thermals, so what did it get up to? The graphics up to 68 degrees. It's pulling around almost 11 watts. So from the wall, it'll probably be about 12 or 13. And the CPU got up to a maximum of 76. So this is really good. And you can see there is no thermal throttling here whatsoever. Now, if I touch it, it's a little warm to the touch. It's approximately about 31 degrees, 30 degrees. And that is mostly where the exhaust vent is, and where that heat's being pushed out, of course, by the fan. Fan noise, very, very hard to actually pick up on my microphone. It's quite low. You barely ever hear it on the 100%. In fact, I don't think I've heard it. No, it hasn't come on yet at 100% because it hasn't reached 80 degrees. My ambient room temperature right now is 25 degrees. So if you're in a hot climate, you're at 35 degrees or something, then do expect more fan noise, and it will probably reach up to 80 degrees then. And now I've just been testing out Linux, and good news is everything is working. So it works fine with the Intel Wireless 3165 chipset. Bluetooth is working, and you can see I've just loaded in my website here. That loaded up really quick. No problems with that. And I believe that this would be a great little media PC and even perhaps a low-end server or file server.
All right, so there's a lot to like about this mini PC. I love the fact that we can upgrade the RAM. It's a little disappointing that it ships with the 4 gigabytes, but I guess Pepper Jobs, they want us to have some upgradability options there. So we can add in another stick of 4 gigabytes if you wanted, and even add 8 gigabytes as I did to run 12 gigabytes of RAM and even 16, even though it's not officially supported. When you look at the user manual inside the box, it says 8 gigabytes max, but in my testing from previous mini PCs like the Intel Nukes, you can run the 16 there and it will use all of that RAM just fine if you decide to multitask really heavily. So the fan in here does make a little bit of noise. It's not completely silent, but when it's on the lower setting, you don't really hear it unless you're right up really close. I mean, you've got to put your ear down to it. You can hear it if it's a completely silent room, and especially when it's on the 100% mode when you're doing something like gaming. It's great to have options in the BIOS that we can tweak, of course, the power limit. I increased it to 12 watts. That boosts the performance. And even on the default 10 watt setting, it will hold a turbo of 2.3 that I've seen when I've done my copper heatsink mods and power limit mods on other Gemini Lake tech. For example, the laptops I review, like the LapBook SE and the TechLast F7 Plus. So the performance is very good. Thermals are good. And I do like the fact that we can run up to 3 displays with this, and we get the 4K 60Hz there, which is great as well, because 4K and 30Hz, if you've ever run a desktop like that, it's very choppy, it's laggy, and not really good. So plenty of upgradability, even the wireless card. So if you're not happy with the performance of the Intel 3165, in my testing, the range seems fine. It's not the fastest. You're going to get a maximum throughput of about 390 megabits per second, possibly 400, depending how far away you are, of course, to your router there. And if you're not happy with that, of course, we've got Gigabit LAN, but you can upgrade that wireless card, which is something you don't normally get. So really, when it comes to cons with this, I'd have to mention just the fan noise if you want a completely silent machine. It's not really bothersome fan noise, but it is there, of course. And the other thing too, it does not have a built-in microphone with it. And when you get it, it ships with only the 4 gigabytes of RAM in just single channel configuration. So it would have been better if they'd put dual channel, or perhaps hopefully in the future, they will give us an 8 gigabyte option. Now this has not been released just yet. And the pricing, we're not too sure at the moment, but it's looking like it's gonna be around about 280 or 300 US there. So it is a little bit expensive. I hope that that price is going to be adjusted later in the future, because it's very close to the likes of the Intel Nukes that I have reviewed. Of course, you need to factor in more RAM with those and your drive. You do at least have 64 gigabytes out of the box to start with this, and you can put in later and expand that with an SSD. So overall, it is a very good mini PC, one of the best Gemini Lakes that I have looked at. And thank you so much for watching this review, and please do like and subscribe for more up and coming videos. Bye for now.